is extreme. We are trying to say that, okay, we make Scrum and Kanban possible, okay, by following all the practices which are prescribed by HP. I mean, on the pro side of it, it's like more technical, so you need to have the OOPS concept very clear, whoever is working on the HP side. The mindset has to be more technical rather than on any other side of it. Actually, it will lead to less bugs in the production because you are following all the TDD and other approaches. Increase in the productivity because you are following the pair programming plus the TDD approaches plus any other practices, CI/CD, so productivity will be more. Less rebugs, of course. Since productivity is increasing and plus you have got the pair programming which is in place, you are having innovation, or there is a scope for innovation, and that is more done in the XP practices. We call it like left shift, wherein all the phases are shifted to the left side. Like testing has to happen in the development, so you have got more TDD return. Okay, the test automation has to be more, so you got less defects on the actual testing side of it. So that's the left shift which happens. CI/CD, if you are having the good tool set with you, then okay, your CI/CD becomes automated. So once you check in the code, everything is fine, it gets deployed to your required environments, right? OOPS on the strong side of it, and this can be used on the mission critical projects wherein you need to have the good quality, you need to have the faster time. Okay, well, probably your sprints are of just 1 week short. Okay, so within 1 week, you design, develop, test, and deploy.
Even at that, adding to it, if in extreme programming, if suppose you are having a self-motivated or more mature team, then you can choose extreme programming. That is added benefit to the project because people are self-organized, they are more matured, so they can adopt the processes, they can do the pair programming, they can do the CI and CD integrations and all these stuff very quickly, they can adopt it. So that is very beneficial at that point where if you are using XP, that is very good. That is added point onto it. Now we are talking about the first side of it.
Okay.
Yeah. Just to add in this, first of all, why we need these technical practices. So we all know that our Scrum is always time boxed or our Sprint is time boxed, right? So to achieve technical excellence, we have to definitely follow some of the technical practices. Otherwise, what will happen, everybody will be in a hurry to develop something and give it to the client. And again, client will come back and say, there are a lot of bugs, there are a lot of rework for the team. So again, a lot of demotivation for the team members will be there. So we have to see how we can deliver the things with good quality. Whether you can commit for less work, but ensure that whatever we are delivering, it is of good quality and less rework. So for that, we have a lot of technical practices, which we have on the other side. If time permits, we'll go through in just 1 or 2 minutes. And as part of the cons, I will say, if you will tell your team members that, okay, we have to follow this set of practices, so first thing is the mindset. I have written already my code. Now you're asking me again to go for and do refactoring on the code, which is already developed, which is already in my repository. So the thing is, I should have that mindset, okay, I am going to improve the quality of my code, and these are the set of things which I should follow. So if that mindset is not there, it is difficult for me to do refactoring or any other technical practice to apply on that. If I am doing this, I should have the good skill set, then only I can do that. Otherwise, again, that will be a problem. I will disturb the functionality itself. I am not going to improve it, I will disturb the existing functionality. Third thing is, you should have enough or a good set of tools available with you, which will help to deliver the things on time. Another important thing, we say simple design as part of your refactoring, right? So simple design means what? Do design of only those user stories which you have planned for your parent sprint. You need not to do end-to-end design. So your design is evolving, your architecture is evolving. But if you don't have a full product vision, or if you don't understand the end-to-end product kind of thing, it's difficult for you to deliver the things, and definitely it is going to come back as a lever. So that is one of the challenge. Design has to evolve. So these are some of the challenges which we thought should be there as part of the extreme programming practices.
I want to add one point. Extreme programming based on the we have to do the better at the first time. So it will be avoid the rework. And these are the continuous integration, test-driven environment. Is helping us to do the thing better at the first time. This is the main advantage. But it is implementing this thing is a very complex.
I think we are short of time. Just one question I'll ask. Why is extreme programming called extreme programming? Everybody knows?
Yeah, because they say whatever you do, do it to the extreme. Just don't do for the sake of doing it. So if you say that we are doing, let's say, refactoring or a pair programming, do it in a proper way. Like
right,
somebody said, ki, do it up to extreme. That's why it is called as extreme programming
yeah.
or extreme.
Right. So like quick integration is important. So they take it to the extreme and do continuous integration, right?
Yes.
Code review is important. They take it to extreme and do pair programming.
And
it helps you do continuous code review.
Right.
So take it to the extreme level, and that's why shorter cycles and everything. Yes,
right.
Very good job.
Even I guess, as per the previous history, in 1960, that particular methodology is being firstly used by NASA. But they haven't, at that point of time, they don't have any kind of name. But came back and used that particular method, and that is you know used by NASA into Mercury name of project. So that's why he had to put the name like extreme programming, because it is going up to extreme levels. So that's why they have something extreme, and they have defined certain methodologies onto it and practices, set of practices onto it. So that exactly the motto, I guess, as for the previous history that I'm aware of.
So just to be clear and distinguish from other two streams, seems.